Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, bitches and motherfuckers, welcome to another edition of Chronic Confusion for whatever day this is out on. Look at your calendar, look at the time, look at the date, and that is what episode this is. So, and that's our fancy intro music, which will have a more professional, appropriate intro on it in the near future. And even an intro video eventually when we get our shit together. What's up, Cody?
Not much. Good to be back. Good to be back.
Be back, man. Yeah, so anything new and exciting happened since last week?
Let's see. I went out and saw a band called Mac Sabbath.
Mac Sabbath. What is a Mac Sabbath?
A Mac Sabbath is a Black Sabbath cover band who the members of the band dress up as various McDonald's characters, and they play Black Sabbath songs with the lyrics changed slightly to be about McDonald's.
Like, can you remember any of the specific lyrics?
Like, there was a part, he's like, he said, an unhappy meal, like a, I can't think of what the actual Black Sabbath song is, but it's like.
What was their version of Iron Man? What did they say?
Like, well, I've got it on my phone, but I don't think we can play it without their express permission.
I don't know, man. They might be cool with it, you know? They might.
I mean, hey, Matt,
can they really copyright those
songs?
Well,
that's the thing. They can't, but Black Sabbath can. And
nah,
it is
true.
The music is verbatim Black Sabbath. Like, I was really impressed with the musicianship of the members.
Well, that's cool. I'm just trying to picture in my head, like, how they could parody Iron Man into, like,
I don't. I have to, like, I'm so, dun, 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 in unhappy meal, right? Like, that wasn't Iron Man. That's the song.
Yeah.
I can't think of what that song's called. But you know what I'm saying. That,
well,
humming,
I'm just trying to.
Right?
I am Iron Man.
Dude, I'm telling you, man. Like, all right. So the guitar player was wearing a Mary McCheese helmet on, and it had these like war elephant tusks coming out of it, and like he'd hit those fucking power chords, and he'd be like, meow, and he'd do like the little pick thing where he held his hand up, like, you know, like, yeah, I know, I'm a guitar god.
I'm a guitar god in a cover band.
Yeah, it sounds like you're listening to Black Sabbath on the radio.
Well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I'll have to show you that video after we're done here. But maybe, I can't think of
that song, man, they used to do in the commercial for Big Macs? It's like, two off beef patties, lettuce,
yeah, yeah,
onions,
lettuce,
special
lettuce,
sauce on a sesame
seed
bun.
Yeah.
There was more to it, I think, but like, you could put that to the Iron Man melody.
Probably.
Two all beef patties, special sauce and such, you know, that's cool. I like. Are they like a national band, or are they local?
Yeah, well, I know that Saturday they're in Louisville, and Sunday they're in Lex, and like they said, it was their first time to Kentucky. So,
okay, so they're definitely a traveling band.
Yeah,
that's just like, what was I gonna say? Fucking pothole. Already pothole at the foot. It's such an American thing to have a heavy metal band dedicated to fast food.
Like, just a parody.
Fat.
It was so great.
We're so fat in this nation that even we have heavy metal music that is dedicated to the shit that makes us fat.
All right, hold on.
I think McDonald's.
Oh, okay, all right. It's not called Iron Man.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Frying Pan. I have frying pan.
Okay, well, that's not as clever as I thought it would be.
Cows, we're going to grind. Oh, wait, we can't even sing a...
Yeah,
yeah, okay, so
I've already probably done too much of the melody.
Fuck.
At this point. All
right, sorry, guys. But yeah, check them out. They're interesting if you can see them live do it, just because it's kind of like a spectacle show, if you know what I mean. Like, they had little props, like it was like an inflatable Ronald McDonald but it had like a fucking Terminator style face on it, and its eyeballs were lasers shooting out into the crowd. So that's it was hilarious. Pretty cool. It was cool.
So we'll talk more about fatness in a future episode. But this episode is all about something that I'm getting into this weekend coming for local people in Kentucky and surrounding. If you're within driving distance, you should definitely come out for this little event here, Scarefest 8 at the Convention Center in Lexington, Kentucky. It's right underneath Rupp Arena, which is the big arena downtown in Lexington. It's Heritage Hall. Is that what it's still called? I think it's called Lexington Center now or something like that. I haven't been there in forever. But I will be emceeing, walking around with a microphone, making general announcements, and then pretty much goofing off, having fun with it. I'll get to...
You've got special access.
Yeah, I mean, kind of. Yeah, definitely. But, like, I'm not going to be able to just go hang out with George Romero. You know, like, I'll have a job to do. But I'm hoping that maybe out of this will come perhaps some interviews for the show.
Yeah.
That
would be very
cool. I'm thinking about maybe on Sunday, maybe even Saturday, taking my laptop and my microphones.
Yeah.
And maybe doing a little something from the show floor. But we'll see.
If I was only off work.
Yeah, damn, dude, I was going to say, if you could even make it out for an hour or two one of those days.
Like, I mean, we'll talk about it, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you definitely have a better chance than just the regular ticket buyers to go hang out with George Romero, though.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because, I mean, like, you're like, yeah, you see this badge? I'm better than you.
Let's see here. All celebrities are scheduled to appear all 3 days unless otherwise stated on their banner. So let me get this up here. Basically, all right, well, let me tell you what my day was like today.
All right.
So I had to go to the convention center tonight, and I had to be there by 6:30 for, like, just kind of a general briefing on what was going to be going on and what they were expecting of us and whatnot.
Yeah.
So now I went out my door at, like, 4 o'clock because my business cards were delivered. So I went to get them off the porch, and the sky was clear.
Yep.
It was nice. The weather was nice. I came back inside, you know, cut myself off from the outside world for an hour and a half, and, you know, got ready and all that stuff. And then I was running a little bit behind because I fucking lost track of time. But I go to leave and open up the door, and it is pouring. it hasn't rained in weeks. Like, it hasn't a really good rain. There's been a few isolated showers here and there in the central Kentucky area, but it hasn't really rained in, like, a couple weeks.
Right.
I didn't even know it was supposed to rain. But I open the door, and it's just pouring down. So already I'm running behind. I'm going to have to drive slower because it's a fucking hurricane big bitch going on out there. It's ridiculous. And my back driver's side tire is flat. Not completely flat. It has a slow leak. But it was flat enough to where I'd have to fill it up. So not only am I running behind and it's raining, I'm going to have to stop and put air in my tire in the fucking pouring rain. And, you know, that's going to take at least another 5 to 10 minutes on my trip. So that was that. And then, of course, it was like 6 o'clock when I finally got on the road, and traffic in downtown Lexington is a nightmare at that point in time.
Oh, yeah.
Plus, there's all kinds of road construction going on. It was, like, finally, I ended up getting there at, like, 7:05 or something, way late. But luckily, I didn't miss anything. But it was just one of those days where, oh, and my windshield in my car just fucking completely fogged over for no good reason, like, when I got on the interstate. Like, as soon as I hit the interstate, the windshield of my car fucking fogged over, and I couldn't get it unfogged, so I had to pull over for like 10 minutes.
I hate that. I hate that so much.
I had the fucking defrost on full blast, and it was just making it worse. Like, I tried it on the heat, I tried it on the air, like everything. It just would not unfog.
Like, so I'm sitting on the side of
the road. Yeah, the wipers were fine, but...
No, but I mean, like, it doesn't get the fog off.
Yeah, no. So, yeah, that was my journey today, and I was just like... God, road raging like crazy.
And see, like, here's something that most people probably wouldn't understand. All right. People are thinking 6:30 in the evening. you know, that's late in the day. You should have had no problem. Well, first of all, as two people who work night shifts primarily, 6:30 is early in the morning. Yeah. Okay? You know, that's pretty early for
a
night shift.
People don't
person.
Seem to grasp the concept that if you work a night shift job, your day is still mapped out the same as somebody who works a day shift job. It's just at a different point in the day.
Yeah, it's the opposite 12 hours.
So, yeah, I might sleep until 5 o'clock in the afternoon, but if you apply it to other people that work morning jobs...
That sleep until 5 a.m.
Yeah, that sleep until 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning, I'm sleeping the same amount of hours,
yeah.
The same exact hours, just you, p.m. instead of a.m.
You sleep all day, what's wrong with
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I go to bed at like 11 a.m., usually anywhere between 9 and 11 a.m., and I get up around 4 or 5. You know, that's
my day. We
have
risen above the belief that survival is based on the ability to rise at 7 a.m. 5 days a week.
Yeah, I mean, and again, when you're going to bed at 11 a.m., it's the same thing.
Yeah,
just at a different point in the day.
Yeah, I mean, I wish I could go to bed at like 8, but I'm normally up until 11 or 12.
Exactly. So, yeah, and that's just... another pothole pretty much pertains to nothing, but that was my journey to get to the convention center today, and I was just so happy to finally get back home and just sit down and not have to worry about anything, because I was so stressed out. Let's see, which one was it? Was it this one? Yes. Okay, so here we are at the Scarefest website. It's going to go through some of the people that are going to be there. So, again, if you're in the Lexington area, if you're in anywhere near Kentucky within an hour, two-hour drive, you should come. They claim, now I'm not disputing this fact, but they claim it's the biggest horror convention in the U.S. My personal opinion, it's been bigger in past years. I'm not really trying to talk shit, but... and honestly, a lot of these people, I haven't really been keeping up with the paranormal and the horror communities and all that stuff in recent. So these people might be bigger than even I know, you know. But I've been doing some research, so I'll know what I'm talking about when I'm emceeing. And I've met a lot of cool people. I was there today. I passed out some business cards, so hopefully we get some new listeners.
That'd be good.
And I'm going to be passing them out this weekend. Oh, and I've decided that... I'm going to have my business cards. If you come and you say, hey, I heard you talking about this on the podcast, I will give you a business card and I will put your name into a drawing for a $50 gift card.
And if I was there, you could touch my beard.
Yeah, you know. So I'm going to be giving away a $50 gift card. This has nothing to do with Scarefest themselves. This is just something I'm doing, kind of hope to grow the channel. Even people I'm giving out the gift cards to, I'm going to be like, hey, if you subscribe in front of me right here, right now, I'll enter you in this drawing. But if you come and you tell me that you heard about it through the podcast, I'll give you 2 entries into the drawing automatically. And if you get a friend to subscribe right in front of my face, I will also give them an entry. So, then Sunday I'm going to do the drawing. And you don't have to be there to win on Sunday. I will contact you some way and get it to you.
It doesn't cost you anything to subscribe, and you could win a gift card.
And it takes like 2 seconds.
It's a win-win.
So a $50 Visa gift card, and I will be doing the drawing on Sunday on my own time, and I will contact the winner personally.
You could spend it anywhere on anything.
Yes. All right, so George Romero is going to be there. We all know who that is. Dawn of the Dead. You know, you see the Night of the Living Dead there. So he's going to be there, I'm guessing, all 3 days, like it says.
That's
right
there.
That's
what it says.
And doesn't say otherwise stated, so that's awesome. I met him, I think, at the Pittsburgh Comic Con back in 2007. He's a pretty cool dude. Writer of Bubba Hotep, Don Coscarelli. Have you ever seen that movie, Bubba Hotep?
No.
Oh, my God,
I've
dude.
I've seen Phantasm. Did he actually write that one, too?
He might. I mean, I guess it says he did.
I mean, I thought Phantasm was older. That guy doesn't look old. So.
He might be. But Bubba Hotep is hilarious. It's fucking Bruce Campbell as Elvis in a retirement home fighting a mummy with a black John F. Kennedy. It's hilarious. I might have it around here somewhere, and I'll let you borrow it.
All right.
The tall man from Phantasm, Angus Scrimm.
See, look how old he looks. compared to the other picture?
Well, I mean, you know, sometimes old people age well. I mean, he might have been old when the movie was made. That other guy might have been like 18 or something.
Maybe.
You know? Jodie Pearson, also from Phantasm. I guess he was an actor, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. It's been forever since I've seen that movie. The Lady in Lavender. Kathy Lester. Special effects on Phantasm. I think they should just change the name to the Phantasm Convention.
Yeah, it's a Phantasm. It's a Phantasm Reunion.
A Michael Baldwin. Now that's a name that you can milk. The Baldwin name, if you're in acting. Reggie Bannister, also from Phantasm. Oh, those were all okay. I see.
Yeah.
That's why I was like, "What the hell?"
Yeah.
All right, from American Horror Story, you got Naomi Grossman, and man, she is way hotter than that character she played.
Definitely.
I would have never guessed that she looked like that.
Nope. Good makeup work, guys.
Dude, that character, it freaked me out so crazy.
One of us.
Yeah,
one
dude.
Of
you've
us.
Seen that show, right?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that character was so creepy. I had nightmares about that. Ma Petite.
That woman is so tiny.
Yeah, she is.
She's a full-grown woman. She's a woman the size of a toddler. It's so...
It's crazy.
It's so... Well, I mean, she was in the right episode, or the right season. Freak
so,
show.
So we got Adelaide.
Yeah, from the first season.
Yep. Legless Susie. That freaked me out. Which is bad because she's really legless.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to say that that's
right,
freaking.
Same with me.
Within the context
thing.
Of the show, it freaked me out.
Right, exactly.
That's Rose Siggins. It'll be cool to meet some of these people, man. I'm really excited. Erica
Amazon
Irvin.
Eve. Yeah, oh, yeah. Shit. She she does modeling.
Paul is the illustrated seal.
Well, he doesn't actually. Yeah, he was the guy that had all the tattoos on him.
Okay.
But you see how his arms are?
Yeah. Okay, I got it now.
House of a Thousand Corpses.
Rufus.
Captain Spaulding.
Yep.
Sid Haig. I want to meet Sid Haig.
Dude, surely you can come out for an hour or two.
Yeah, I want to meet Sid Haig. Oh my god!
Come out, meet him. I'm gonna try to get him on the show.
I just walk up to him and be like, "Can I just have a picture of you?" And you like do whatever you want. You can kill me. Like you can literally kill me in the picture.
I've heard he's a pretty good dude.
I mean, he's done so much great work.
Yeah, and it's crazy that like the biggest thing he's known for is Captain Spaulding,
because that was just such a. Instant hit, man.
And it's such a crazy role, too. It's like out there.
I went and saw that when I was like a freshman or a sophomore in high school.
Yeah.
So
Fright Night from the original Fright Night, Charlie Brewster, William Ragsdale. That movie's awesome.
That is.
The remake wasn't bad.
It wasn't bad, but
the original was
I liked
so much
the
better.
First one. Yeah. Because of her. Because she from Married with Children.
Yep.
I was
Darcy,
like, oh my god.
Marcy Darcy.
Yeah, Marcy Darcy. Evil Ed.
Yep.
Well, he looks pretty much the same.
Yeah, he does. All right, from Christine. The Christine car is going to... Oh, also, I don't know if... I don't remember seeing it on the website because this actually excited me today when I was there. The Supernatural car is going to be there. The Impala.
Oh, yeah,
the
yeah,
Supernatural
yeah. Yeah.
Is going to be there. So
what
I'm pretty excited
about
that.
What about the actors?
I don't know. We'll see. It's been a while since I looked at this list, so we're kind of discovering this stuff together, really. Christine from Ghostbusters and the Christine car thing. Stephen Tash was in Christine and Ghostbusters, what I was trying to say. Malcolm Daner, also in Christine and Godzilla. And then the car is going to be there, so that's pretty cool. The Munsters, Marilyn Munster. Pat Priest.
Wow.
Eddie Munster. Butch Patrick. Man, and the cool thing about Butch Patrick is, like, he is so, like, a lot of these people that were child actors back in the day are, like, really, like, fuck that. I don't even want to acknowledge it, you know?
Yeah.
But he is so embracing of it, and he's so happy to just represent, and that's awesome. Because the Munsters were awesome, and he's awesome. So, the Addams Family got Wednesday Addams. Lisa Loring. And then Friday the 13th, the first guy that played Jason, the kid Jason, Ari Lemon. Some filmmakers, the Booth Brothers, Dead still, I haven't seen that. So, I'm sorry, guys. I haven't seen it, but I will.
They've got a whole thing going, don't they?
I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I like the hats, gentlemen.
They're committed.
Yeah.
Face Off, I have not. That's the one about makeup and shit, right?
I'm not sure.
I think I've seen
never,
an episode
I haven't
of that.
Seen any of that, but that sounds pretty cool.
I think
now.
I have seen an episode of that, maybe a couple episodes. So that was RJ Hattie. You got Ben Peter, Roy Woolley. You got the Daughters of Legend. Starting to get into uncharted territory for me. She's the daughter of Vincent Price, man. I love Vincent Price.
I don't understand. I don't know how he kept his mustache like that. Like, I couldn't do that now, and we have much better technology for that kind of stuff.
I'm going to be shaving most of my shit off for the convention.
Oh, man, that's lame.
Just because I hate trimming. Like, trimming, like, I used to do the trimming thing, and I hate it. So, always end up fucking it up and having to take it all off anyways.
Oh, man, I could do it.
I Spit on Your Grave.
The remake, not the original.
Yeah. And also Supernatural and The Fast and the Furious. I'm guessing a rider?
Yeah, it looks like something to do with Scooby-Doo because of the Mystery Machine.
Yeah, the Mystery Machine's going to be there. Moses was one of the walkers that Michonne carried around.
Huh.
Oh shit, John Morrison from WWE. Which is now Johnny Mundo on Lucha Underground. Which is really good. If anybody out there is a wrestling fan, if you like the late 90s and shit like that as far as wrestling goes, and
yeah,
it's a pretty good show to watch. Like, they're really kind of old school. The Monster Mobile is going to be there. The Dragula. Vampire Santa. Ooh. Sal Lizard. That guy looks awesome. I'm going to have a fucking sandwich with that guy. Let's sit down and eat some cookies and drink some hot cocoa with Sal Lizard, hopefully. Best-selling author, Stephen Simones. Is that how you say that?
Simones.
Okay, we'll go with that. Nashville on ABC, Kayla Perkins. I know that chick.
Hold on, why is she... Like, no offense to Nashville, but that's not a horse. Oh, okay. Wait. Does that say Nightmare Fuel?
Yeah.
She was in Nightmare Fuel? Then you probably do know her, because I know the people that made Nightmare Fuel.
I think she worked I think she worked at where I work at one point in time, because I was in a movie with her.
Yeah, she looks like it.
Oh, we were in a movie together. I think she was in that movie a long time ago called Hope and Play.
Well, if she's in Nightmare Fuel, you can probably see her tits.
I'm pretty sure I'm friends with her on Facebook.
Hey, Kayla.
What's up, Kayla?
What's up, girl?
Kayla Perkins. But yeah, I'm pretty sure she's from around here. I think we worked together back in the day.
I mean, that's clearly Nightmare Fuel, and yeah. I know that's a movie made here in Kentucky.
Mr. Boogie from Sinister 1 and 2.
Bagul.
So that's the horror guests at Scarefest. Again, this is going on this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. What's that, the 11th through the 13th?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much all day. I know Friday it starts kind of later. Okay, so from like... Now, how do you feel about paranormal TV shows, man? Like Ghost Hunters and stuff like that.
They're interesting to watch. Yeah. But, like, I'd much prefer just to do it than to watch other people do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, go into, like, some little creepy place and just hang out for a little bit.
We're gonna purposely delve into a pothole here, I think. Because I need to...
A purposeful pothole.
A purposeful pothole. We're not gonna dodge it this time, folks. There we go. We need a person that just works this shit. So I can just talk. It's too distracting. We need to hire somebody.
I could talk to somebody.
But like, yeah, as far as like ghost hunting and paranormal stuff like that goes, again, we've talked about it before. I'm an atheist, I'm a skeptic. But I have had, it's like, okay, Corey Taylor from Slipknot, I just read one of his books not too long ago, where he talks about, like, he does a lot of paranormal investigating and stuff like that. And okay. Because he's an atheist, too. And his reasoning behind it, which I kind of agree with.
Really? The guy from Slipknot's an atheist? Wow. Yeah.
Well, his reasoning behind, like, is pretty much the same as mine as far as, like, believing in the paranormal and shit like that and not believing in God and stuff is because, like him, I have had experiences in my life that I can't explain. Now, there could be scientific explanations behind it, and I'm just not smart enough to know what they are, and that's
swamp gas.
Yeah. So, and he is pretty much the same thing as like, and he tells his ghost stories and what he's experienced, and he's like, you know, it freaked me the fuck out, and it was scary, but you know, maybe there is something out there that would explain it that science just hasn't discovered yet. So you don't know. You kind of always have that mindset about it. Like, all right, for instance, when I was a kid, moving into this house in Lexington on Catskill Court, right off of Man of War. I was like four or five years old. My sister was 10. Our cousin was there. He was also my sister's age. And we were out in the front yard playing while the adults were carrying in furniture and boxes and shit. And
the good old days.
Yeah, man. You know, out of nowhere, like, we didn't even see him ride up, but this little fucking blonde-haired kid, this little boy, just rides up on his bike. All we pretty much heard was him, like, getting off his bike, and we turned around, and he was there.
Yeah.
And he was like, we thought he was just fucking with us, you know, because kids do that sometimes. But he was like, you know, there was a guy that was killed here, and he's buried in the backyard, and kind of that whole fucking thing.
Yeah.
Which may not have been true. He may not have been buried there. He might have been killed there. Who knows?
It's a really dick move for a kid. What's up, kids?
But yeah, that was pretty much all he showed up to tell us. And we were like, okay. But then he took off, and we kind of turned around and went back to what we were doing. And then, literally within seconds, turned back around, and he was gone. Now, this was a court. Like, every pretty much house had their yards blocked off. You couldn't cut through a yard or anything. We never saw the kid again after that. Within seconds, he was gone. That was weird as fuck. That same house, my dad would get, like, held down in bed, and, like, shit would, like, attack him.
Yeah.
And if my mom told him to stop, it would stop.
Like sleep paralysis type.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Which is what people ascribe it to.
Yeah.
But, you know, those things coupled together. My mom would have the shed in the back padlocked at night, and she would go out in the morning, and the padlock would still be on, but the light would be on, you know, inside of it. You could see the light shining through.
Right.
You know, and something was turning on the light. And I had some weird dreams in that house. Christmas Eve one year, I had bunk beds, and I always slept on the top bunk. And it had a pretty good guardrail on it. Like, it was really hard to just come over it, you know, and I ended up flying over the top of it. The guardrail did not move. It stayed on the bed. It wasn't like I knocked the guardrail off.
Yeah.
You know, like, I ended up flying over top of the guardrail and landing on the floor below, which was, I don't know, 8 feet up, you know? So yeah, there was some weird shit that happened in that house. Plus with the boy telling us the guy died in it, you know, it's kind of weird.
Yeah.
So you have experiences like that and you're like, you know, there might be something to this.
I can tell you an experience, man.
Yeah.
My roommate can back it up. My buddy Austin can back it up. I mean, I called in at Coast to Coast last year for Halloween, which is when they do the Ghost to Ghost show.
Yeah.
You know, people call in and tell their stories. Well, so what happened is there's this place in Winchester. It's called Ghost Bridge.
Yeah.
All right. I think they actually did, like, a little ABC news story on it recently, but whatever. So, like, thing is, like, apparently some kids, like, jumped off and killed themselves. Jumped onto a train or hung themselves or something like that.
Yeah.
Well, this is back in high school, like, I guess sophomore year, because we were just starting to drive. And basically, the bridge is in much better condition now than it was then. Like, there were holes that you could literally fall through in the bridge. Just, like, big holes. Like, if you ran over with your tire, your car would get stuck more than likely. But you could literally fall through them. They're holes small enough to break your ankles in. Things like that. We'd gone out there a lot. And, you know, we'd heard, like chains or something. But that could have been a cow against a fence. But, you know, we knew the area really well. But the thing that we had always heard is if you went out there at midnight on a full moon, that's when you'd see the ghosts. So we were like, well, actually, it said that if you drove over the bridge, your car would stall out.
Yeah, there's a bunch of places that have a legend exactly. like that.
Well, so our buddy Jeremy is driving this old, like, 1992 Bronco. And he drives it over
the
bridge.
Well, that's your problem right there, buddy. He's driving it forward.
Yeah.
I love fucking rednecks around here to play. Oh, why are you fucking driving forward, man? You can find yourself on the side of the road, man. Chevy's where it's at.
Exactly. And I'm like, it doesn't matter who makes it.
Yeah, it's a fucking car. It does what it does.
But so he drives over, and it stalls. And, like, he opens the door, and, like, right where he has to step out is one of those massive holes. Okay? Well, so he gets out the passenger side. We push the car back off the bridge. And we didn't have any jumper cables with us because we're high school kids and we were dumb. So, like, you know, his car is completely dead. So, me and my roommate William, we drive back into town, grab some cables, drive back out there. Hook the cables up, car turns right back on so the lights come back on. And at the other side of the bridge, we see this, like, figure. Alright? And it's like, kind of like the same glowing color as like moonlight, like silvery white with like a little bit of blue, I guess. And it looks like a girl with long black hair sitting down, like with her knees up to her chest and her hair down. So we kind of start walking towards it.
Sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, well, you know, this is what we wanted.
Yeah.
We start walking towards it, and I can't make this up. This is going to sound bullshit, but we got about halfway out across the bridge, so about halfway to where it was, and we started hearing, it wasn't just me, because we all looked at each other when we heard this, and we all turned and ran, but we heard the noise from the fucking Grudge. Like, I'm not even kidding you. Like, I know it sounds bullshit, but, like, I swear, there are people who I know and in contact with today who will verify this to you.
That's crazy.
We turn and fucking ran. I mean,
clear. I ran and I don't run.
Clear as day. A girl with black hair sitting with her knees to her chest with it, like, down in front of her. And, like, I don't know. I've been out there before and I've heard what sounded like a little girl saying hello. It might have been a cat meowing, but it sounded like, you know, cats can sound like babies crying. But
yeah, you know, that's the crazy thing about cats is like their meows aren't like dogs bark to kind of communicate with other dogs and to let people know there's danger and shit like that. But cats, like, their meows are specifically there to mimic human baby voices.
Yeah, and
That's what they're there for.
I love cats. I love cats, but I mean, when you hear a cat in heat and you think that someone's neglecting a baby, it's creepy.
It's unnerving. But yeah, that's fucking crazy.
Yeah, man. I guess that answers your question. That's how I feel about the paranormal.
Well,
that experience.
The reason, again, going back to Corey Taylor's, it's like, you know, the reason we don't really believe in God and the claims of religion is there's really, like, yeah, there's people that claim they've had personal experiences, but at the end of the day, there's no fucking evidence that can back any of that up at all. But whenever it comes to, like the paranormal and ghosts and shit like that, if you've had a personal encounter with something that could be construed as a ghost, like, you really have no choice but to at least believe it somewhat.
Yeah.
You know, to at least say, hey, there might be something to this. Now, if Jesus himself was ever to appear to me and be like, hey, I'm Jesus, I might, you know, include him in that category. You know? But at this moment, like, because, like, the whole thing with religious people and personal experiences, it's always like a feeling. It's always like a tingly feeling. It's always like, oh, I just felt like, you know, but that's just, you know,
That's crowd euphoria.
That's just normal fucking biological processes.
Dopamine.
Because what I figured out after I stopped being a Christian, I got those same feelings of, like, what I would used to say was the Holy Spirit or God talking to me or whatever. whenever something good would happen. Like the first time I saw Marilyn Manson in concert. You got the same feeling watching
a Marilyn Manson concert. Because it was something, as you would during the Sunday service.
It gave me chills up my spine because he put on such a good show.
But I mean, man, that's just so funny. It's the first thing. Yeah, exactly. You're like,
it's a totally opposite end of the spectrum.
Oh man,
but that's what I'm talking about though. Because it's like you get like this. Because I remember that feeling. I was like, man, I always used to just say this feeling was God.
Yeah.
You know, whenever it's like, because seeing Marilyn Manson was something I wanted to do since I was like 13 years old. And finally, when I was 18, I got to do it. You know, I got to see him in concert. He put on a hell of a show. And like from the time that he hit the stage and the first fucking bars of Antichrist Superstar, fucking song, like it hit me. And I was like, holy shit, dude, like this is that feeling, you know, it's the same exact feeling.
Like every time I see Primus, man.
Yeah, you know,
dopamine stuff like that goes off.
Yeah, it's just chemical processes in the brain. So there are people that say they've seen angels and they've seen God and shit, but usually they end up being insane, you know. So anyways, and I think when Halloween gets here, we'll do a whole show about like urban legends.
Ooh, yeah.
And stuff like that, because there's all kinds around Kentucky. Like there's one here in Richmond, it's called Little Egypt or something like that.
Yeah, I've heard about Little Egypt.
It's right up the road here, man.
I've gone up looking for it, can't find it.
It's out on 4 Mile.
Yeah.
We've been on 4 Mile. Basically, what is it? You keep the window cracked and she comes in the car, and if you're not the guy that raped and killed her, as long as you leave the window down, she'll leave.
But if you are, if you don't
if you
let her out,
if you resemble him, or if you don't let her out,
she'll kill you.
You have to leave the window a crack, and then
you
got to
say Little Egypt.
Yeah, then you roll the window up, and then you roll it back down, and she'll leave. It's
weird. You know, I've done it a lot, and it hasn't happened yet, but yeah. Maybe that's the wrong.
But there's all kinds of those things around these parts, man. Okay, so getting back to the paranormal guest, of course, Josh Gates from, was it Destination Truth? And this one says Expedition Unknown. He's one of the, he's cool. I don't really have any problems with him.
Yeah.
He seems kind of legit.
He looks like he shops at like a, like an outdoorsman type place.
Like one of those. Well, I can't say he's not really an outdoorsy person, because most of the shit he does on his shows is pretty outdoorsy.
Yeah.
But
he looks like he should be advertising for, like, a bass shop or something.
Exactly. The Tennessee Wraith Chasers from Destination America, I've never seen that, but I'm sure they're cool people. Ghost from Ghost Asylum. Chip Coffee.
Chip Coffee.
I'm going to hold my tongue.
Hey, man, you should go get a reading. Come on, man. He might give you some good news. Like, be like, dude, how is our podcast going to do in like 10 months from now? He'll be like, you've got 1 million subscribers.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I'm trying.
I mean, that's
to.
Another thing. Like, you've never actually had a kind of experience like that, and neither have I.
Yeah.
So, like, that's something that you're
much
more
skeptical
on.
From what I've heard, he's been caught in some frauds. I don't know that for a fact. That's just allegedly.
Yeah,
that's one of those things, like psychic mediums, especially he was on this show, Paranormal State, that I watched a few episodes of, and he just seemed, to me he seemed very, not so genuine, but he might be. I mean, I'm not trying to speak bad about him, because like, you know, we're going to have to coexist for a few days, and he might be a cool dude. I'm sure he is. Other people have met him and said he's a good dude. So, I mean, I don't really have anything personally against him.
Yeah, man,
I'm just not so sure that I buy in. Because I do think that it's possible for some people to have some sort of extra sensory perception.
Yeah.
But I think it's more possible for even more people to exploit the fact that a lot of people believe in it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And take
like
advantage
that, what
of
was
people.
That
I'm not
that,
saying that's what he does.
Like
I'm
that
just saying,
John Williams guy.
Yeah. And I'm just saying that it's hard to tell the difference sometimes.
Yeah, get a reading from him. Ask him about our subscribers.
I might. Michelle Bellinger. Bellhanger.
Bellhanger.
author and occult expert from also Paranormal State. I don't really remember her too much.
Nope.
Dead Files, Amy Allen. Ghost Hunter, Sean Porter. Don't really. I haven't watched Ghost Hunters in he's got a fucking Star Wars 3-4 years. Yeah.
So I'm cool with him.
Kim the Happy Medium.
I don't enjoy that.
Don't enjoy what?
Kim the Happy Medium.
I've never seen her.
That just makes her sound like that other fucking bitch that does the medium shit on fucking
Sylvia Brown or something.
Probably. I don't know. No, just like that TV show where the woman's like, "Oh, so good. I'm gonna come talk to your dead husband." Why?
Yeah,
do you
I think a lot of times that's people taking advantage of people. Yeah,
she looks like an advantage taker.
Maybe, you know, she might be cool. I don't know. Ben Hansen, fact or faked? I like that show. They kind of take a skeptical approach to things. Steve DeChevy. Shivey?
I'm not gonna. Disc Hivey.
Disc Hivey?
He looks very serious, though, doesn't
he? Paul Bradford, yeah, he does. He looks like he's explaining some shit.
Yeah, no, I'm breaking it down for you on a molecular level.
Paul Bradford from Ghost Hunters International. Again, I haven't watched Ghost Hunters in ages, so I can't really speak one way or the other. I did meet Steve Gonzalez from Ghost Hunters back at the Pittsburgh Comic Con in 2007. He was really nice. We were supposed to work on some shit together, and he ended up flaking out, but he was still pretty cool.
Yeah.
Wes Forsythe.
A paranormal filler.
I don't know what that means.
Like it says Dark Matter Radio, yeah. So he's on, maybe he just comes in and he's like, "Hey guys, there's some ghost action in Tennessee tonight."
Could be. Shay Lynn,
spirit artist.
Featured psychic investigator.
What does that mean, spirit artist?
I don't know. Maybe she draws spirits. Like, she does, the characters at, King's Island and shit. Like,
yeah.
how much do spirits pay for a character? That's what I want to know. But yeah, I don't know what that means. I've heard she's pretty cool, though. People were talking about her today.
Yeah.
Patty Starr, she is the, she's the person that runs the whole thing.
Yeah.
She's really nice.
Yeah, I've heard about her, and I understand that, a friend of mine, she told me about her, but it was kind of expensive to get involved with it at the time.
Yeah.
Cause she has her own little paranormal groups that she takes out, but it's a little expensive if I remember right. I just don't have the money to spend on that kind of stuff.
Several years ago, myself and a pretty big group of people went to the Waverly Hills Sanatorium in Louisville, which is supposed to be supposedly one of the most haunted places in America.
Yeah, I've heard people have told me stories about it.
Ghost Hunters got some good footage there, and so did Ghost Adventures. We had some pretty cool stuff happen. We heard the piano in the lobby playing when nobody was near it. Not just a ding, but it was an actual somebody was actually playing some shit, and that was freaky. We were in the death tunnel, which was this underground tunnel that they used to cart the dead people out in so that the patients didn't see them.
Right.
And we were sitting in there, and rocks were thrown at us. Now, that could have been somebody fucking with us, but even though, we're pretty sure there was nobody around. But there's, these holes in the ground, kind of ventilation holes that kind of... And you can, see when you're up on the ground, the top of you can look down and see into the tunnel. So somebody could have been up there fucking around. I don't know.
Yeah, yeah.
And there was some other shit. People got some cool EVPs and stuff. But yeah, that was a cool place. And the thing about that place is the thing that makes me question its validity is all the publicity that's been on it recently in the past few years and shit with the Ghost Hunters going in there and Ghost Adventures. And then when you realize that when those shows aren't there doing their thing, they're charging people $1,000 a night to come and investigate.
Yep.
You know, that kind of makes it there might be some kind of activity going on here, but they're really exploiting the fuck out of it. And I think they're turning it into a hotel now.
Yeah, that's what I've heard.
So, yeah, then it'll probably be a couple hundred bucks a night for a room, and you can have your own experience and shit.
They have a limit on the number of people you can go in with a group, too, don't they?
I think you can have up to 14 or 15. I think we had, like, 12. And ended up being, like, 150 or something a person.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it was fun. Like I said, we had some weird shit happen. The weirdest shit, though, was the fucking tour guide. he was the night watchman or whatever, and he was kind of make sure we didn't fuck with anything. But we would be in a room, like, doing our thing, and all of a sudden he would just pop up out of nowhere. like he was trying to scare us or something. Like, he didn't say boo or anything, but, like, you'd fucking be in this room thinking you were alone, and, like, there was no other way to get in there besides the way you got in, and all of a sudden he would come through this other door that you thought was, like, a closet or something. And it was like, dude, what the fuck? He was weird.
Making sure you aren't fucking shit up.
Yeah. But, so, yeah, the whole, like, I just kind of feel like it was, the timing is a little too perfect, you know, for them to have those shows go on there, and then all of a sudden, like, they're opening up. I mean, I'm sure they had a demand, like, I'm sure a lot of people wanted to go and check it out for themselves, so I understand charging for it.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's kind of like, you know, it just kind of seems exploited to me. But, you know, it was fun. Can't really complain too much. All right, so we'll go over one more thing here because we're getting kind of into the time on this. So,
into the time.
So, guest speakers this year. Let's see what we got here. Paranormal investigator Adam
Bonnet.
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 Bonnet. Author Elizabeth Fields. Was like still in the shadows. I don't read much. Mostly I listen to audiobooks. So if you're on Audible, Elizabeth, I might check you out one of these days. But if you're going to want me to read some shit, it ain't going to happen probably. Psychic medium RJ Deacon. I don't know. It doesn't say. I guess you'd probably figure out what days they're on if you actually... Just go to the website and look it up.
Yeah, but I mean, it's not saying... I guess they're speaking each day.
I don't know. They'll probably have certain times they're there.
Corvus Nocturnum.
That's got to be his real name, right?
Yeah. No one ever changes their name.
Yeah, you know. He's Erie America. I don't know what that means.
Well, Erie's spelled kind of like Lake Erie.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Did you ever watch that show, Erie, Indiana, back in the day? That show was good.
Yeah.
Psychic medium and spiritual healer, Reverend One Eagle Feather. Well, you know, if you only got one eagle feather, how great can you be?
But he's Native American. So, talk to him about some peace pipage.
Dude,
if he's a spiritual healer, he's got to have something good.
He's got to have some good spiritually healing herbals.
He's got some caps.
He's got a bag full of peyote.
Yep.
At all times.
Just like, it's time to go on a vision quest, my friend.
Yeah. I don't know that he's a reverend, though. That kind of throws me off. I mean, reverend, isn't that kind of more of a Christian thing?
Christianity is just the title.
Yeah.
It's just his title.
We'll go with that.
Because he didn't make it the chief.
Yeah. You know, he's only got one eagle feather, too, so.
Yep.
Spooky Scotty Productions, Z Talk Radio Network.
Scotty Rorick.
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 Author Jason McLeod. What's that say? Dark Siege?
Dark Siege, The Nightmare Returns. He looks pompous.
You know. Probably, maybe.
I know that this is a photo shoot, and they're like, you know, like, he probably had to do, like, 100-some-odd different poses.
Yeah.
And they picked that one because it was the best, but I mean, like, that, it doesn't look natural for him.
Your best pose is the Superman pose.
Yep.
The lazy Superman pose, even.
Oh, well, he's rocking it.
Yeah, he is. He looks confident. He's probably a good dude.
He's got one of them cool little bowler shirts.
Yeah, you know. Terry Page. What's LMT?
Limited? Maybe.
No, surely not.
Long Mountain Tusk.
There we go. Para investigator, Terry Page. She'll be speaking on it. Psychic medium, and Reiki master. My mom does that Reiki stuff. I'm not so sure about it.
What is it?
It's like I don't even know. It's like I can't even explain it. Here, let me see something real
quick. Well, hey, man. She'll explain it to you. She's a reverend. See, it's not just Christianity.
I guess so. It's like it's a Japanese method of like healing. It's like meditative healing, something like that. My mom was really into it. I don't know. She might still be.
Well, she's a master.
Yeah. My mom might like to meet her. Again, that kind of plays into my whole skeptic way of thinking. I just... I don't know. I'd rather put my faith in modern medicine
and yeah.
stuff like that. But hey, whatever works, whatever helps you sleep at night, you know, I'm not going to hate on you for it. Paranormal investigator and forensic analyst George Turner at the crossroads of myth, theory, and reality. Okay. So again, like, you know, I'm really out of the loop. I'm sure these people have a following or else they wouldn't be at this convention. I'm just like, you know, I'm kind of going through them because I don't really know anything about them. OL State Reformatory.
What's that?
Scott Sukel. I guess it's maybe kind of like Waverly Hills. Maybe one of those places where you can go and hang out and meet some ghosts. I don't know.
Well, I don't like Ohio State, so.
O-H-I-O.
C.L. Parker.
C.L. Parker. Again, another author.
Supernova.
I don't read books. Sorry, Miss Parker.
What did you write, Jack Montgomery? What the hell?
He's just an author. Don't ask questions. that's the face of a man that says, don't ask questions, motherfucker.
I'm here. I wrote things.
I wrote stuff.
I have a napkin full of writings.
I have a whole... Cabinet full of books.
We're just picking fun.
Yeah. The Sasquatch, or the Squatch Detective, Steve Coles. Oh, God. We got to get this guy for an interview.
He'll kick your fucking ass.
He looks interesting.
He'll kick your fucking... Look at him. He'll kick your fucking ass. Like, he's militia level Sasquatch.
That's a guy you want to have on your side when martial law kicks in.
Yeah, because, I mean, you don't piss him off.
Yeah.
You're nice to him. If he wants to eat the beans, he eats the beans.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Sasquatch, I feel like in all the years people have been talking about it, something would have been found by now. You know, like there would be some kind of concrete evidence.
Maybe they all died.
Maybe. Spiritual warrior.
Chris Deadman. Sorry, no.
It's pronounced Deadmon. Come on, man.
I just can't. When your name is Chris warrior. Deadman, you can't be a spiritual warrior because your last name is Deadman.
What does spiritual warrior even mean?
To me, that says like they're
like are
they're
you going
a warrior
out
warrior for Jesus?
Are you fighting ghosts? Are you fighting like alongside angels?
Oh, that would be a pretty funny skit. Like all right, so like straight rip of the ghost hunters. Like you're like in there, you set up all your cameras. It's like, all right, we're ready to start going. This is going to be awesome. You walk in there and like,
oh, shit.
You walk in there like, fuck all you ghosts and shit.
Oh, fuck. I've been sitting for too long. Talk about some shit. I left a Red Bull in the freezer and it's probably fucked up.
Oh, no. Frozen Red Bull. All right. But yeah, he just walks in there and he's like, fuck you ghosts. I ain't fucking ready for this shit.
Look at this thing, dude. I got this out of a crane machine. Does that not look like a penis?
What? Is it a... Is it a dog?
I think it's supposed to be a dog, but it looks like a big penis.
It's like a... What the hell? Animal pals. More like animal foul lick.
Yeah, it's... I wish I could... I'll take a picture of it and put it up somewhere later. But, yeah, so... Sorry, Chris Deadman. I'm not really trying to make fun of you. I'm just...
But your name
the
and title your
title is just kind of fucking...
Your title and your name. Yeah. But he's wearing, like, the same kind of shirt that the author was wearing, too.
Yeah. It must be a thing. Doe Network Organization? What is that?
Doe.
Doe, a deer, a female deer?
Right, yeah, all right, man. Don't get me singing.
Todd
hold
Matthews.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. That might be the guy who talks about the people who go disappearing in the park. And if
God, fuck, it's frozen.
If so, he's got Trump... Trump status hair. He does. Todd Matthews.
Son of a bitch. Fucking frozen Red Bull.
Microwave it.
Yeah, I'm going to put a fucking can in a microwave. Todd Matthews. I mean, is it DOE maybe? Dead.
It doesn't say so.
What did you find?
Well, I mean, up there it doesn't say so. I'm going to do the donut.
I was thinking maybe that was an abbreviation.
All right. Let's see. Lost and found in the Cumberland, an extraordinary, ordinary guy from Livingston, Tennessee, is helping solve missing unidentified cases across the nation. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. This is a guy who, I mean, it may not be exactly, it looks like it is, though. He's investigated all of these missing people from, like, national parks and stuff like that. Like, and
Does DOE stand for, though?
Like Doe, like I guess, like John Doe or something?
Oh, okay, yeah, okay, that makes sense.
Let's see. He was an unlikely candidate to be featured in magazines such as People and Master Detective for his life to be considered by... What?
What?
I don't know.
He does good stuff, man. If he's helping to find missing people, he does good stuff.
Yeah.
Todd Matthews is cool by me. So anyway, moving on. Paranormal investigators, Gettysburg Ghost Gals.
All right. What's up, ladies?
You know, like to have them on the show.
How you doing?
You know, among other things. They look like friendly females.
Wait, hold on. Wait. Playboy. Right there.
Yeah.
They're on Playboy. So
that's that
they
works
need
for me.
To be on our next episode.
And we're gonna have to actually use video.
Yeah, and they've been on Fox News and Playboy, so we'll get a lot of people watching.
I'm sure they're cool, you know. Gettysburg Ghost Gals.
MTV.
It's not something you see all too often, you know. I'm not trying to, again, because I'm not a very attractive person, but I've noticed in the field of the paranormal, there's not very many attractive people, especially females. So, you know, it's refreshing to see some attractive females doing the good work.
Because Scarefest isn't going to spend the money that Comic-Con does to hire hot models to sell you video games and
I mean,
stuff.
I've heard that there's usually some pretty hot cosplayers that show up, so we'll see. Patty Starr again, Layla Cook.
Whoa.
Bud Janesse.
But, like, why is he wearing that?
Because he's a professional, dude.
I mean, that's like judge or like cardinal status level attire.
Well, maybe he is in the field of the paranormal.
I mean, he looks
top
professional,
of the chain.
Doesn't he?
Yeah, you know, he's the top of the chain, man, in the paranormal world.
I guess it really is on how you dress.
Yeah, you know, they say appearance is everything.
Fuck that.
Let's see, is there anything else that we should talk about? Artists and entertainers, what do we have here? Joel Robinson? Oh.
Official event designer. Saturday and Sunday only.
Eric Puckett. Angel Campbell.
MDMFA.
DVDA.
DVDA.
Award-winning graffiti artist Danny Green. Shane Garner. Larry Lutz, character actor. Movie props from Maximum Overdrive and Scream.
That's
you
cool.
Seen that movie?
Maximum Overdrive? I haven't.
I love that movie. Oh, you've never seen it? That movie's awesome. It's fucking crazy. It's one of those movies that are so ridiculous that it's just good because it's ridiculous. Wicked Beard. That's not, well, I mean, you know, hey, he looks like he could kick my ass, so I'm not going to talk too much shit.
What? But that's not a wicked
that's
beard,
not a wicked
bro.
Beard, dude.
I'll show you up.
Yeah.
I'm taking your fucking
that
name, bro.
That beard's not winning any... Hold on, let me get this on the screen.
Yeah, get that on the screen, and I'm taking your fucking title, bro.
That beard is not winning any contest. I'm sorry, but, you know, it might in trimming, in the trimming
nope.
department,
nope.
it might.
Nope.
But generally, if you're gonna call something a wicked beard, it has to be like a beard, you know.
I have a beard.
Like, this guy just has some facial hair that he trimmed up nicely. You know, again, he could probably kick my ass. So I'm not really talking shit. I'm just saying.
He'd kick my ass, too, but I'm going to take his name. He has to call himself Trimbeard.
Trimbeard.
Trimbeard is his new name.
His new name is Well-Kempt Beard.
Indeed.
Impossible Magic. Reed and Ashton Masterson.
Now, that's cool. I like magic.
Yeah, magic is cool. I have this whole theory that Jesus was a magician.
I want to see pen and people who have way more money than I do, and they're able to just do so much cool stuff.
Well, come on out for a couple hours, and you'll be able to do it, too.
The 501st Legion. I mean, like, look, dude. All right. That Darth Vader costume dude's wearing right there is a $2,000 costume.
Damn.
$2,000, but I mean, it is movie accurate, lighting up
switches. Oh, so you've heard of these people before?
Yeah, okay. I've seen the 501st at a Star Wars convention, you know? Like, real? I mean, like, the Stormtrooper outfits aren't as expensive, and you can get rinky-dink ones, but I mean, you've got people who have got, like, their shit all painted up to look really cool and everything. I mean, these are guys that I'm like, I wish I was on your level because you make me look like I'm not as cool of a Star Wars fan. So I always have to be like, well, hey, dude, I've got it tattooed, man.
Everybody counts. You're doing your part. They're doing theirs.
They just have more money.
Exactly. Western Kentucky Ghostbusters.
That's cool just because they're wearing the suits.
Yeah. There's the Supernatural car.
And Doctor Who props. You know what? That's probably going to get one of the biggest turnouts. Like, walking up and being like, take a picture of
me. You know what's
going to
suck, though, is that they have those things at the, like, right as you walk in the main entrance. That shit is going to be so crowded. God. It's going to be so fucking crowded right there.
People are going to get stampeded. Why would they put them right there?
Apparently, we're going to have wolves.
Then Wolf Run, they're just allowed to go?
Yeah, I guess so. So that'll be fun.
Wolves walking around the floor.
You might want to wear some clothing that's not easily bitten into if you're going to show up.
Do not bring beef jerky. I know it's a favorite snack.
Do not carry any beef jerky in your cargo pants.
Or anything sweet. It's best to leave food outside, actually.
So the wolves are going to be running amok.
No fresh cuts.
You got the new Ace Ventura and Ernest. I don't know anything about the Ace Ventura dude, but the Ernest guy, he's a good friend of mine. He's a cool dude. Wait. He's actually really good, too.
Wait. Are you telling me that there's a new movie?
I don't know about Ace Ventura, but they are working on a new Ernest movie with this guy. Yeah.
But they're going to do Ernie and Ace's Wild Adventure?
That's what they're saying. I mean, it's like a fan film. It's not like an actual big budget anything.
So, Ernest is back, huh?
Kinda. He's actually endorsed by the original guy that directed and produced the Ernest movies.
Yeah.
So, that's nice. He's legit. I don't know anything about the Ernest guy, or the Ace Ventura guy. But yeah, Billy Crank, he's a funny dude. I'd definitely recommend looking him up on YouTube. He does a pretty accurate impression. He's pretty good. Flint, Michigan Zombie Walk. Are they walking all the way here from Flint, Michigan? Because that would be a hell of a walk.
Well, now, hold on. Why does this look weird? The one that's in black and white looks like it's with an HD camera, and the one that's in color looks like it's old-timey. So, like, I think they messed up on that.
Well, it doesn't even look like it's old-timey. It looks like it was taken with, a shitty camera phone from, like, 10 years ago.
Low-res camera.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of weird. So, Christina Lakey.
Major cleavage going on.
Yeah,
though.
You know, I'm a fan. Yeah. I'm cool with it.
Good job, ladies.
Mystery Machine's going to be there. I actually asked one of my coworkers today if what would be the chances and who do I have to pay to actually be able to smoke a bowl in the Mystery Machine. And I didn't really get an answer.
That means nothing and do it quietly.
Yeah, exactly. So, maybe after hours. Again, I'm not saying I'm actually going to do this, but if there's a funky smell,
grab one of the wolves too.
Yeah, you know, I'll let them guard the door.
That'll end so. No, I mean, put them in there as Scooby.
Oh, okay, yeah. That'll work.
That would end so poorly.
Okay, so DJ 420. Yeah.
Obviously, he's going to want to go into the Mystery Machine
so,
with you.
Me and DJ 420 are going to hang out in the Mystery Machine for about 10 minutes and, you know, get our heads straight. DJ Havoc.
That's Chris Deadman again.
It is!
It's Chris Deadman.
Actually, I think I met that guy today. He's a pretty cool dude.
So he's a spiritual warrior.
And a DJ.
And a DJ.
Of the costume ball. DJ 59. I know that guy.
I
know him from somewhere.
I don't like that name. I'm sorry. You might be good, but I don't like your name, so I can't judge you.
DJ Rain. Scarefest Car. Gandalf's gonna be there.
not
and
the,
Bilbo,
but it's different.
Yeah, cosplaying. Burlesque, sweet.
Hey, look,
dancing
they actually,
bitches.
They do that at the for the Lexington Beard Competition. Actually,
oh, do they?
Yeah, they do the burlesque show, and I mean, like, it's really cool, but there's no nudity. I probably just pissed them all off for saying that too. Like, they do a really good job, but I'm like, I just want to see some nipples. You know what I mean?
Well, you know, it's public.
But it's a beard competition being held in a fucking bar. You gotta be at least 18 to get in there, and
man,
obviously at 18 you can see tits because Deja Vu lets you see tits at 18.
This is true, but you know, it's their thing. They're,
it
you
is.
Know, they're
I don't.
Girls
I don't mean
dignity,
to piss
man.
Them off. I like what they do, but I would like to see some titties too.
You know,
they do the tassel thing though, so it's kind of more like a Cleveland type club.
They do the titty tassels.
Yeah, they got titty. Some of them have the titty tassels. I mean, I know that they had a contortionist, and she was she was in like a tiny little box, and I was
that'd probably be fun.
Yeah, check it out, but. Just know you're not going to see tits.
Well, I mean, I see tits all the time, so it's, you know, whatever. Sometimes you just want to see some good entertainment, you know?
Well, they're definitely good entertainment.
WKGB Ecto 2, which is the most movie-accurate Ghostbusters car I've ever seen.
Yeah.
I'm just giving them
the
a hard time.
The mass hysteria unit.
That looks pretty cool, actually. I would love to have that. I would drive that around everywhere.
Well, you know, cities auction off their old vehicles all
this
the time.
This is true, yeah.
You
that's
could
probably
totally
where they got that
it.
One. So that is the speakers and random other shit. Oh, no, the artist. That's right. Featured vendors. So that's pretty much, okay, Stars Row. Let's see if there's anything there. That's pretty much, we've already covered that, I think. Yeah, that's just details. So, yeah, Scarefest, there's going to be a blood drive.
Ooh.
I don't think I can do that.
AIDS?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I got the AIDS.
Can't catch it twice.
Well, I mean, the thing about it is, like, people, you know, like, they talk down on AIDS, but when you consider the reasons that I gave myself AIDS, which is, you know, obviously weight loss,
yeah,
and pretty soon it'll start kicking in, and, you know, people will be like, how'd you lose all that weight? And I'll be like, well, you know, I did what nobody else would do. I got the AIDS.
And you also talked to Magic Johnson, and he told you the trick how to manage it down to one AID at the end of it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So, yeah, I've got the AIDS just as a weight loss thing. But, you know, it's cool. It was a conscious decision. I didn't just do it for the hell of it, you know. So, I understand the sympathy.
No, it's very responsible of you.
You know, I understand people's problems with it. But just know that I didn't do it in vain, you know. And, yeah, my life will probably shorten because of it. But, you know.
Oh, no, Magic Johnson's fine.
Well, he's got money. I don't really have money. I'm just like, my idea was, you know what, I'll give up, you know, 30 years of my life to have a year or two where I'm in good shape and getting pussy, you know, on the regular.
Well,
so
you have to tell them that you have AIDS first.
You know, I'll wear a condom, you know, it's all good. You know, you know, it's condoms work. They're 98.9% effective. You know, the chances of them getting the AIDS too is very slim. And if they do get it, then you know what? Then I'll just won't die alone. I'll have somebody to die with me.
You've got a friend.
Yeah, you know, I'll have a friend in AIDS. And that's it for this episode of Chronic Confusion. I hope to see you people at the Convention Center in Lexington, Kentucky for Scarefest this weekend. Again, come up to me, tell me that you heard the podcast. I will enter you into the drawing for a $50 Visa gift card, and the winner will be picked at random with this nifty phone app I have called Draw Names Out of a Hat. seriously, there's a phone app, Draw Names Out of a Hat. You just put names in it, and it'll randomly pull out a name, and then that's the winner.
That's
and I will
nice.
Contact you some way or another on Sunday and get the gift card to you. You can either come to Convention Center and pick it up, or I'll deliver it to you personally or whatever. So that's pretty much it. Again, hit the subscribe button. Check us out on Facebook. Give us a like. Follow on Twitter. All that stuff. Shit, I forgot to alter the thing and put your name on Twitter, but you don't use it that much anyways.
At Adolf Klittler.
Adolf Klittler. It'll be on the next episode. I had to change it for that thing the other day.
Yeah, yeah,
So, yeah, thanks for listening, and check out the next episode on Monday. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I try to get these put up. And very soon, I'm going to start putting together best ofs of these video podcasts and putting them up on Stitcher and iTunes. And hopefully soon I'll be getting back together with Glenn to do Don't Get It Twisted and all that good stuff. So until then, you know, be good and watch out for the potholes and whatnot.